Good afternoon, students. Today we are discussing about the photosynthesis in higher plants. So, moving with the first question. Which one of the following concerns photophosphorylation? So, what is photophosphorylation? Meaning of phosphorylation means formation of ATP. Formation of ATP is called as phosphorylation. When ADP and the inorganic phosphate combines together, there is a formation of ATP takes place. It is called as photophosphorylation. What is the photophosphorylation? Photo means light. By using the light energy, when there is a formation of ATP molecule takes place, this one, it is called as a photophosphorylation. Actually, there are three types of the phosphorylation are there. One is photophosphorylation, second one is oxidative phosphorylation, and third one is substrate level phosphorylation. And during the photosynthesis, the light energy is used for formation of ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate. So this process is called as photophosphorylation. So correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. Bacterial photosynthesis involves both PS1 and PS2, either PS1 or PS2, PS1 only, PS2 only. So bacterial photosynthesis, in case of the bacteria, the photosynthesis is anoxygenic. Without the evolution of oxygen, it takes place. So during this one, so it includes only the cyclic photophosphorylation, and it is not associated with photolysis of water, and there is no oxygen evolution is there, and even there is a synthesis of only ATP will be there. So as the PS1, there is no O2 evolution. No O2 evolution is there. So as there is no photolysis of water, photolysis of water molecule. During the light reaction in the PS2, the photolysis of water takes place. As there is no O2 evolution and no photolysis of water, the bacterial photosynthesis involves only the cyclic photophosphorylation. What it involves? It involves only the cyclic photophosphorylation. So it involves only the PS1. So the correct answer is the third option. PS1 is the correct answer. Then moving to the next question. In photosynthesis, energy from light reaction to dark reaction is transferred in the form of ADP, ATP, RUBP or chlorophyll. So in this one, the energy, the process of the photosynthesis includes two. One is light reaction and another one is a dark reaction. During the light reaction, it is a light dependent reaction where the light energy is captured and is converted into the chemical energy in the form of ATP. And these ATP are only utilized, or these are used during the dark reaction where the carbohydrates were formed after the reduction of the CO2. So in photosynthesis, energy from light reaction to dark reaction is transferred in the form of ATP molecules. Correct answer is the second one. Second is the correct answer. In the form of ATP molecules, they are transferred. Then the next one, the C4 pathway for CO2 fixation was proposed by. So as per the photosynthetic pathway or dark reaction, there are different types are there: C3 pathway, C4 pathway and CAM pathway. Among them, C4 pathway of CO2 fixation was proposed by scientist Hatch and Slack, Hatch and Kotschak, and in the year 1966. As the first stable compound in this pathway is a 4-carbon containing substance, so this pathway is called as a C4 pathway. Benson and associates, Kelvin and Benson, what they discovered? They discovered the C3 cycle. Ernon and associates, they discovered the two types of the photosystems, PS1 and PS2. And Rouhani, not associated with the biology. So the correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. DCMU is... Moving to the next question, actually it is the DCMU. What is this DCMU? It is the dichlorophenyl dimethyl urea. It is the dichlorophenyl dimethyl dimethyl urea. This one is called as a DCMU. So what is the role of the DCMU? What is this DCMU? Dichlorophenyl dimethyl urea. This is actually a herbicide. Herbicide means it is a chemical which is used to kill the herbs or weeds. So this herbicide, it inhibits the oxygen evolution and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So it inhibits the O2 evolution and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So this one, it inhibits. So which one is the correct answer? Inhibits the PS1, inhibits PS2, destroys chloroplast, or inhibits oxidative phosphorylation. Here the correct answer, as it involves a non-cyclic photophosphorylation. The non-cyclic photophosphorylation mainly starts with the PS2. So the correct answer is the second one. It inhibits oxidative photophosphorylation. Where it occurs? It occurs during the process of the respiration, not during the process of the photosynthesis. So the correct answer is the fourth one. Then moving to the next question. Identify from the following a characteristic pigment which contain copper containing protein. Plastoquinone, ferredoxine, cytochrome or plastocyanin. So here the correct answer is the fourth one. Plastocyanin is a pigment. So plastocyanin, in short, we call it as a PC. And we can observe this one during the Z scheme of the photosynthesis, or during the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, we are observing this plastocyanin as a PC. It is a copper containing protein, and that transfers the electron from. So it is involved in electron transfer. Cu containing protein or copper containing protein, and it transfers the electron from cytochrome B6F to the reaction center of the PS1, that is the P700. So here the correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. In C4 plants, the bundle sheath cells have thin wall to facilitate gases exchange, have large intercellular spaces, are rich in pep carboxylase, have a high density of the chloroplast. So in C4 pathway, bundle sheath cells are there. The C4 plant shows the unique anatomy, and that anatomy, what it is called? It is called as a Kranz anatomy. What is this Kranz anatomy? In this one, the vascular bundles are surrounded by large thick walled cells. So what these cells are called? These cells are called as a bundle sheath cells. What these cells are called? These are called as a bundle sheath cells. These bundle sheath cells, they show the thick wall. The walls are not thin. Here the thin wall is given, and they are impermeable to gases exchange. So the first option is the wrong one. Have large intercellular spaces? No. These cells are almost compactly arranged without any intercellular spaces. But here large intercellular spaces are given. So this option is wrong. Are rich in pep carboxylase? No. Inside the bundle sheath cell, there is a C3 pathway or Kelvin pathway takes place, and they contain the enzyme Rubisco, ribulose biphosphate carboxylase oxygenase enzyme. So this one is the wrong one. What is this one? This one is the wrong one. So the next one, what it contains? They show the high density of chloroplast. Yes, in them the chloroplasts are more in number. So the correct answer is the fourth one. Question number 7, fourth option is the correct one. Then moving to the next question. So in C4 plants, the C4 plants are different from C3 plants with reference to the. So there are two types. As per the photosynthetic pathway, two types of the pathway are there. One is the C3 pathway and another one is the C4 pathway. What are the differences are there? Types of pigments involved in photosynthesis, the number of NADPH that are consumed in preparing sugar, types of end products of photosynthesis, the substance that accepts carbon dioxide in carbon assimilation and first stable product. So in C3 and C4 plants, the type of pigment, same type of the photosynthetic pigments are there. So this is not the difference. Second, when the number of NADPH that are consumed in preparing sugar, same number will be there. The end product will be sugars only. The substance that accepts the carbon dioxide and carbon assimilation and first stable compound, this is the major difference. In C3 plant and C4 plant, the first CO2 acceptor, in case of the C3 plant, the CO2 acceptor is a 5 carbon containing sugar, that is the ribulose biphosphate, RUBP. While in C4 plants, the primary acceptor of carbon dioxide is the PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate. Here, in case of the C3 plants, the first stable compound, which is the first stable compound, it is the 3 carbon containing 3 phosphoglyceric acid. While in case of the C4 plant, the first stable compound is a 4 carbon containing oxaloacetic acid. So the difference will be there. So it is a 3 carbon containing substance and this is a 4 carbon containing substance. So for these plants, we call as a C3 plants, and these plants are called as a C4 plants. So the correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. Kranz anatomy is a morphological diversity in the leaves of C3 plants, C4 plants, both A and B and CAM plants, crassulacean acid metabolism. So Kranz anatomy, it is the, what will be there? Kranz anatomy, it is a morphological diversity in the leaves of C4 plants only. Just I told, what is the Kranz anatomy? The vascular bundles are surrounded by thick-walled, compactly arranged cells that are rich in chloroplast. So this one, they surround the vascular bundle like a wreath. So this one, what it is called? It is called as a Kranz anatomy. So the correct answer is the second one. Then moving to the next question. Which of the following is a simplified equation of photosynthesis? So, 4 equations of the photosynthesis are given. Which of the following is a simplified equation of the photosynthesis? The raw materials needed for the photosynthesis are CO2 and H2O. Among them, which is the correct equation of the photosynthesis? The fourth one is the correct equation of the photosynthesis. CO2 plus 2H2O. In presence of light energy and chlorophyll molecule, it forms a CH2O, N means it is a carbohydrate, water and oxygen is released. And we write this equation. This is a simplified equation. What is the actual equation of photosynthesis? 6CO2 plus 12H2O, it gives rise in presence of what? In presence of light energy and the chlorophyll molecule, what it produces? C6H12O6. Plus 6H2O plus 6O2, and these O2 are released. This is the present day equation of the photosynthesis or the modern equation of the photosynthesis. So here the correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. PGA, the first carbon dioxide product, was first discovered in bryophytes, pteridophytes, angiosperms or algae. So the correct answer is the algae. The Kelvin cycle was first discovered in a green algae, unicellular algae, and that one is the chlorella. So the chlorella, it is a unicellular green algae, and most of the photosynthetic researchers were studied in this algae. So the correct answer is the fourth one. Then moving to the next question. The light reaction of photosynthesis end up in formation of NADH2, ATP, sugar or NADPH2. Here the correct answer is the NADPH2. During the light reaction of the photosynthesis, capturing of the light energy takes place and there is a formation of ATP and NADPH2 are there. So it involves mainly the Z scheme of the photosynthesis, or it involves the photophosphorylation. During the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, the final electron acceptor, it is the NADPH2. So NADP gets the electron and it becomes reduced, and there is a NADPH2 is there. So it is the end product of the light reaction. So the correct answer is the fourth option. Then moving to the next question. Synthesis of one molecule of glucose requires 6 CO2, 18 ATP and 12 NADPH, 6 CO2, 12 ATP and 18 NADPH, 6 CO2, 30 ATP and 12 NADPH, 6 CO2, 38 ATP and 12 NADPH. So, for the synthesis of one glucose molecule, there is a need of 6 CO2, 18 ATP and 12 NADPH2 are needed. So, during the Kelvin cycle, there is a for formation of one glucose. So, for the formation of one glucose, how many CO2 are fixed? 6 CO2 are fixed. So, as per the reaction, just only we studied 6 CO2 plus 12 H2O. And this one, for the formation of glucose or during the Kelvin cycle, there are three steps are there. First one is the carboxylation, second one is the reduction, and third one is the regeneration. During the carboxylation, after the carboxylation, there is a 1 ATP is used, and during the reduction, NADPH2 are used, and during the regeneration, again ATP are used. So, for 6 CO2, there are need of 18 ATP and 12 NADPH2. NADPH2 will be there. So, the correct answer is the first one. Then, moving to the next question. In dark reaction, regeneration of RuBP needs 2 molecule of ATP, 1 molecule of ATP, 3 molecules of ATP and 4 molecule of ATP. So, during the dark reaction or during the Kelvin cycle, what will be there? There is a regeneration of RuBP will be there. So, RuBP is regenerated from RuMP. One molecule of RuMP reacts with the 1 ATP and there is a formation of RuBP plus ADP will be there. So, the correct answer, it requires a 1 molecule of ATP, and this occurs during the regeneration step from the fructose. There is a regeneration of RuMP is there, and this RuMP is converted into the RuBP. So, the correct answer is the second option. Then, moving to the next question. Pyruvate plus ATP, it produces the Y. That is the, what it produces? It produces the Y. And this Y, what will be there? What this Y will be there? You are going to identify PEP plus AMP plus HDPO4. So, this is the regeneration during, this is the step of the C4 pathway. In the C4 pathway, inside the mesophyll cell, there is a regeneration of PEP will be there, phosphoenol pyruvate. Regeneration of phosphoenol pyruvate is there. And during that one, which enzyme will help? So, the pyruvate reacts with the ATP and there is a formation of PEP, that is the phosphoenol pyruvate takes place. There is a formation of phosphoenol pyruvate is there, and this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoenol pyruvate dikinase. This reaction is catalyzed by phosphopyruvate dikinase. Correct answer is the third one. Then moving to the next question. During non-cyclic photophosphorylation, in which of the following 4 electron produced through photolysis will enter? So, during the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, there is a, what will be there? Photolysis of water is it. The 2 molecules of water are broken down into 4 protons and 4 electrons plus O2 is released. During this one, these 4 protons accumulates in the stroma. And find the 4 electrons, where they will go? These 4 electrons will pass to the PS2, that is the reaction center of the PS2, that is the P680. And from the P680, they are transferred to the, or they are passed to the intermediate electron carriers to reduce the NADPH2. So, here the correct answer is the PS2. These 4 electrons were passed to the reaction center of the PS2, that is the P680. Then, moving to the next question. Select the wrongly matched pair with regard to the C4 cycle. So, which one is wrongly matched? We are going to identify primary CO2 fixation PGA product. Whether it is correct or wrong, this This one is wrong, because primary CO2 fixation, after primary CO2 fixation, in case of the C4 plant, which is the first stable product, it is not the 3-PGA. The PGA is the product in case of the C3 plants. Here, the first stable product is a 4-carbon containing oxaloacetic acid, OAA. So this one is wrong. Site of initial carboxylation is the mesophyll cells, as it is correct. The initial or the atmospheric CO2 is fixed in the mesophyll cell, which contain the enzyme PEP carboxylase. In the mesophyll cell, C4 pathway takes place and they contain the enzyme PEP carboxylase. This is correct. Primary acceptor is PEP. This one is correct. C4 plant example MAGE is correct. So what you are going to identify? Wrongly matched pair. So in this one, which is the wrongly matched pair? The first one is the wrongly matched pair. So the correct answer is the first one. Then moving to the next question. Cyclic photophosphorylation results in formation of NADPH, ATP and NADPH, ATP, NADPH and oxygen and ATP. During the cyclic photophosphorylation, only there is a formation of ATP is there. There is no formation of the NADPH2. So the correct answer is the fourth option. So it involves only the PS1. And this one, as the PS1 lacks the enzyme NADH dehydrogenase, so this one is not able to reduce the NADPH reductase enzyme. So the PS1 is not able to reduce the NADP, and because of that, there is a formation of only ATP is there. So the correct answer is the fourth one. Then moving to the next question. The wavelength of light absorbed by the PR from phytochrome, a PR form of phytochrome, this should be form. The PR form of the phytochrome is 640 nm, 680 nm, 720 nm or 620 nm. Here, the PR form, the phytochrome, there are two forms are there. The phytochromes occur in two forms, PR and PFR. The PR can be converted into PFR or the PFR can be converted into the PR. So when the PR absorbs the red light, so when this PR absorbs the red light, it is converted into the PFR. And when the PFR absorbs the far red light, it is converted into the PR. So the PR, it will absorb red light, means it is up to the 680 nm. So the correct answer is the second one. Red light means 680 nm. It can absorb the light of 680 nm. Then moving to the next question. Which of the following characteristic out of 1, 2, 3, 4 are exhibited by C4 plants? So the four characters are given. Among these four characters, you are going to identify the character shown by the C4 plant. First one, plant's anatomy. Yes, it is correct one. Oxaloacetic acid. Yes, it is the first stable product. So this is also correct. Then large bundle sheath cell. This is also correct. Found only in desert area. No, this is not correct. So these plants can be grown in the tropical areas. So these plants, commonly they are found growing in the areas. They are not only found in the tropical areas. So fourth one is wrong. So the correct 1, 2 and 3 statements are correct. So the correct answer is the first one. 21st option is the correct one. Then moving to the next question. Which of the following is concerned with carbon dioxide fixation? Krebs cycle, Kelvin cycle, Ornithine cycle or glycolysis? Very simple question. The CO2 fixation takes place during the Kelvin cycle only. Krebs cycle, glycolysis, these are related with the respiration. Where there is a release of CO2 is there. CO2 is not fixed, but there is a release of CO2 is there. Ornithine cycle, or it is also called as a urea cycle, and this urea cycle mainly occurs in the liver cells and the kidney cells. There is no fixation of CO2 is there, but there is a removal of excretory waste will be there. So the correct answer is the second one. Then moving to the next question. Quantum yield of photosynthesis is 33%, 9%, 12% or 8%. So Here, what is the quantum yield? Quantum yield, it is the measurement of the light intensity and rate of photosynthesis. Quantum yield, it is the measurement of the rate of the photosynthesis. How much photons of light are required to release the one molecule of O2? That one is called as a quantum yield of the photosynthesis. And it is observed that the quantum yield of the photosynthesis is about 12%. So it is the how many photons, right? Photons are required. How many photons are required for release of one O2? That one is called as a quantum yield. And it is about 12%. Then moving to the next question. RuBP plus CO2. Rubisco X in the given, identify the X in the given. So, two molecules of 2 PGA, two molecules of 3 PGA, two molecules of 4 PGA, or two molecules of 1 PGA. Which one is correct? RuBP, it is the initial acceptor of CO2. It is a 5 carbon containing substance plus CO2. This is the first one carbon contained. Then, togetherly, what they form? It formed the 3 PGA and it is a 3 carbon containing substance. How many molecules of 3 PGA are formed? 2 molecules of 3 PGA are formed. So the correct answer is the second one. So the 6 carbon containing substance is formed, but it is not stable. That unstable compound immediately converted into 2 molecules of 3 carbon containing 3 PGA. So when one RuBP fixes the 1 atmospheric CO2, there is a formation of 2 molecules of 3 carbon containing 3 PGA will be there. So the correct answer is the second one. Then moving to the next question. Which crop utilizes solar energy most efficiently? Potato, sugarcane, wheat, and rice. Among the given options, the sugarcane is the C4 plant. Among these given options, the C4 plant is the sugarcane. And as you know, the C4 plants are photosynthetically more efficient than the C3 plants due to the absence of the photorespiration. And because of that, the sugarcane crop utilizes more solar energy as compared to the potato, wheat, and the rice. So the correct answer is the second one. Then, initial CO2 acceptor, extent of photorespiration, enzyme catalyzing reaction that fixes CO2, presence of Kelvin cycle, leaf anatomy. Which one does not differ in C3 and C4 pathway? So some differences between the C3 and C4 pathway will be there. Which is not different? Which will not differ? Which does not differ? You are going to identify. Initial CO2 acceptor, different. In C3 pathway, which is the CO2 acceptor? RuBP. And in C4, which is the CO2 acceptor? OAA. Extent of photorespiration in C3 and C4. So here RuBP is the initial acceptor in case of the C4 plants. PEP, phosphoenol pyruvate is the initial acceptor of the CO2. Then extent of photorespiration here in case of the C4 plants, photorespiration is present. In case of the C3 plant, photorespiration is there. In C4 plants, no photorespiration. Then presence of enzyme catalyzing reaction that fixes CO2. In case of the C3 plants, which enzyme is there? Rubisco enzyme. And in case of the C4 plants, PEPCage, that is phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase enzyme is there. Then presence of Kelvin cycle in C3 plants, definitely Kelvin cycle is there. Even in C4 plants also the Kelvin cycle is there. Inside the bundle sheath cells of the C4 cells, the Kelvin cycle takes place. So the Kelvin cycle is common in both C3 and C4 plants. Then leaf anatomy, the normal leaf anatomy will be there in C3 plants, but in C4 plants, what they show? They show the special leaf anatomy, and what we call? We call it as a Kranz anatomy. So where there is no difference, the presence of the Kelvin cycle, it is the common thing that occur in both C3 and C4 pathway. So the correct answer is the second option. Only the fourth statement. Then moving to the next question. Which one is true for? Which of the following is true for photosynthesis? Reduction of CO2 and water, oxidation of CO2 and water, reduction of CO2 and oxidation of water, oxidation of CO2 and reduction of water. During the process of photosynthesis, there is a reduction of CO2 takes place. The CO2 is reduced to carbohydrates and oxidation of the water takes place, and due to the oxidation of water, there is a evolution of O2, or O2 is a byproduct of the photosynthesis due to the oxidation of water. So the correct answer is the third one. Then next question. Emerson effect explains the phenomenon of transpiration, absorption of water by roots, photosynthesis, or respiration. Emerson effect, it is associated with the photosynthesis. Emerson, he studied the quantum yield of photosynthesis and he found that the rate of photosynthesis increases with increase in light intensity up to the red light. Beyond red light, there is a sudden decrease or drop in the rate of photosynthesis will be there. Later on, he exposed the plants to the simultaneous shorter wavelength of light and longer wavelength of light, and he observed that the quantum yield of the photosynthesis is greater than the sum total of the two lights when they are used separately. So after the Emerson effect, and this one, it is called as a red drop, and the decrease in the rate of photosynthesis beyond red region, it is called as red drop. And when the two lights of, or two different lights, shorter wavelength and longer wavelength, they were exposed to the plant simultaneously, the quantum yield or the rate of photosynthesis is increased than the sum total. That one is called as the Emerson enhancement effect. And after that, only the two photosystems were discovered, PS1 and PS2. So this entire one is related with the photosynthesis. Correct answer is the third one. Then moving to the next question. The first step in dark reaction of photosynthesis is the dark reaction, not the light reaction. Dark reaction, light independent reaction, where the reduction of CO2 takes place. Formation of ATP, it is associated with the light reaction. Ionization of water, yes, it is associated with the light reaction with the PS2. Attachment of carbon dioxide to a pentose sugar, yes. During the dark reaction, first the atmospheric CO2 is fixed by a pentose sugar, that is the RuBP. So this is the correct one. Excitement of electron of chlorophyll by a photon of light, this also occurs during the light reaction. Here the dark reaction is asked, so the correct answer is the third one. Then moving to the next question. Plants adapted to low light intensity have larger photosynthetic unit size than the sun plants, higher rate of carbon dioxide fixation than the sun plants, more extended root system, leaves modified into spines. So the plants adapted to the low light intensity, the plants that will grow in the shade, low light intensity means the plants that will grow in the shade, they show the lesser rate or the low rate of the photosynthesis in them. The rate of the photosynthesis is less, and these are commonly called as the sciophytes. These sciophytes, what they show in them, there is a less light is there, they will receive the very less light, so the rate of photosynthesis will be less, but they show the larger size of the photosynthetic unit. Correct answer is the first one. Why they show the larger size of the photosynthetic unit? Because the photon will strike to the chlorophyll antenna to absorb the maximum, whatever available light is there, to absorb that available light, they increase their size of the antenna complex. So the correct answer is the first option. Then moving to the next question. In which of the following wavelengths photosystem one is inactive? 780 nm, 680 nm, 690 nm or 550 nm. So the PS1 is inactive. PS1, the reaction center of the PS1 is the P700. So what is the meaning of P700? Is reaction center will absorb the light of maximum of photon 700, and this will be inactive at the, so Which of the following wavelength is inactive? Maximum it can receive the P700. 680 it can receive, 690 it can receive, 550 it can receive. But it will be inactive at the 780 Nm. So the correct answer is the first option. Then moving to the next question. How many Kelvin cycles are required to produce the 5 molecules of glucose? So for the one glucose molecule production, how many Kelvin cycles, how many turns are required? 6 turns of the C3 cycle were required, because during each turn, 1 CO2 is fixed, and for the formation of the one glucose molecule, 6 CO2 are required. So 6 turns are required. So how many glucose molecules are there? For the formation of glucose molecule, so 5 into 6, how many? It will be 30. 30 turns of the Kelvin cycle were required. So the correct answer is the third one. Then moving to the next question. C4 plants differ from C3 plants in respect to. So which are the differences? Again, you are going to study. Number of CO2 molecules used. Substrate that accept the CO2 molecule. The final product. Number of ATP form. Number of CO2 molecules used. The same number of the CO2 molecules are used. So this is not the difference. Substrate which accept the CO2 molecule, yes, it is different. You know now which is the substrate. In case of the C3, it is the RUBP. And in case of the C4, it is the PEP. So that is the correct one. The final product in both of them, the final product is C6H12O6 only. Number of ATP form, same amount of the ATP will be formed. So the main difference is the second one. So the correct answer, second one. Then moving to the next question. Identify the 5 carbon containing compound from the given option. Which is the 5 carbon containing substance? It is the RUBP. It is a 5 carbon containing substance. OAA, oxaloacetic acid, 4 carbon containing substance. TPGA, 3 carbon containing substance. NADPH2, it is the reduced coenzyme. So the correct answer is the first one. The next one. In Kelvin cycle, if one molecule of RUBP is carboxylated, then how many PGA molecules will be formed? So, one RUBP is carboxylated from one RUBP. So, when one RUBP accepts the one CO2, how many? There is a formation of PGAs there. How many PGA will be formed? 2, 3, 4 and 5. Just only I discussed. So, how many PGA will be formed? So the correct answer is the first one, because it is a 5 carbon containing substance and one CO2. During this one, actually there is a one unstable compound is formed, that is the X, and it is immediately converted into 3 carbon containing substance, and then there are 2 molecules of the 3 PGA will be there. So the correct answer is the first one. Moving to the next question. Photorespiration is the light dependent reaction in which utilization of oxygen and release of H2O, oxygen and release of H+ takes place, oxygen and release of CO2 takes place, oxygen and release of ATP takes place. What is photorespiration? Light, so it is the release of the CO2 in presence of the light, that one is called as a photorespiration. And during this one, oxygen and release of CO2 takes place. Correct answer is the third one. There is a release of oxygen and the CO2 takes place. Then consider the following statements regarding the photosynthesis. Among them, so how many statements are correct and incorrect you are going to identify. ATP formation during photosynthesis is termed as photophosphorylation. Yes, it is correct. Kranz anatomy pertains to leaf. Yes, this type of the anatomy found in the C4 plant leaves. Reduction of NADP and NADPH to occur during the Kelvin cycle. Reduction of NADP and NADPH to occurs during the Kelvin cycle. So this one is not correct, because reduction of NADP occurs during the light reaction. So during the light reaction only, the reduction of the NADP takes place, and its oxidation occurs during the dark reaction. Oxidation of NADH, NADP it takes place during the dark reaction, and its reduction occurs during the dark reaction, or it is the Kelvin cycle. But what is given? Reduction of NADP is given, it occurs during the light reaction. So this statement is wrong. In chlorophyll molecule, magnesium is present in phytol chain. This is also wrong. In case of the chlorophyll molecule, this is the structure of the chlorophyll molecule. Magnesium is present in the ring structure of the chlorophyll molecule, or it is found in the porphyrin head. This one, what it is called? Porphyrin head. So the first and second statements are correct. Third and four are wrong. So the correct answer is the first option, 36. First option is the correct one. Then next question. How many molecules of glycine is required to release one CO2 molecule in photorespiration? The process of the photorespiration is completed in three cell organelle. One is chloroplast, second one is the peroxisome, and third one is the mitochondria. In the mitochondria, the two molecules of glycine, they combine together and they form the amino acid serine with the release of CO2 and ammonia. There is a release of CO2 and ammonia will be there. So how many molecules of glycine are required? Because of that, two molecules of glycine are required. Then moving to the next question. Cytochrome oxidase contain Fe, Mg, Zn or Co. Cytochrome oxidase, it is a intermediate electron carrier. It is a ferrous containing or iron containing protein which is present in the complex 4 of the mitochondrial electron transport system. So the correct answer is the first one. It is an iron containing protein. Then moving to the next question. Who proved that oxygen evolved in photosynthesis comes from water? Kelvin, Mayer, Blackman, Rubin, Hassid and Kamen. So, who proved that oxygen is evolved? The first was is it was given by the Fannell. Fannell, he explained that the hydrogen from a suitable oxidizable substance reduce CO2 to carbohydrates, and there is a release of O2 will be there. And this was experimentally proved by the Rubin, Hassid and Kamen. They used the radioactive oxygen molecule and they proved that during the photosynthesis, whatever the O2 is released, it comes from H2O, not from CO2. Kelvin, C3 cycle discovered by Kelvin, Blackman, law of limiting factor, Ernst Mayr. So he described the some other photosynthetic reactions. The next one, hexose monophosphate shunt takes place in endoplasmic reticulum, cristae, cytoplasm or mitochondrial matrix. Hexose monophosphate shunt, it is related with the respiration and it mainly occurs inside the cytoplasm only. Then next one. Oxaloacetic acid changes to the malic acid by the action of oxaloacetic dehydrogenase, malic dehydrogenase, PEP dehydrogenase or RMP dehydrogenase. Oxaloacetic acid changes to the malic acid during the C4 pathway inside the mesophyll cell. Which of the reaction takes place inside the mesophyll cell? The atmospheric CO2 absorbed, it is fixed by the phosphoenol pyruvate and there is a formation of OAAZ, 4 carbon containing substance. This oxaloacetic acid, it is converted to another substance, another 4 carbon containing acid, that is either malic acid or it is converted into the aspartic acid. When it is converted into the malic acid, this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme malate dehydrogenase. And when this OAA is converted into the aspartic acid, this reaction, it is catalyzed by the transaminase. The enzyme transaminase is responsible for conversion of OAA into aspartic acid. So here the correct answer is the second one. Then moving to the next question. Which of the following statement is false in case of the C4 plant? So in C4 plant, which is the false one, you are going to identify CO2 acceptor is Rubisco in mesophyll cell. So this is the wrong one. Inside the mesophyll cell, which is the CO2 acceptor? CO2 acceptor is the PEP carboxylase, not the Rubisco. It is the PEP carboxylase. Rubisco is present in the bundle sheath cell. They asked about the mesophyll cell. Carboxylation occurs in mesophyll cell, yes. The atmospheric CO2 is fixed in mesophyll cell. Leaves out two types of cells, yes. One is mesophyll cell and bundle sheath cell. Mesophyll cells lacks Rubisco, yes, they contain only PEP carboxylase. So which is the false? The first one is the false. So correct answer is the first one. Number of carboxylation occurs in Kelvin cycle is 0, 1, 2 or 3. So the Kelvin cycle is divided into three steps: carboxylation, reduction and regeneration. The number of carboxylation occurs is the one only. The RuBP accepts the CO2. This process is called as a carboxylation, and only one carboxylation is there. So the correct answer is the second option. Then moving to the next question. Generally, plants adapted to dry tropical conditions have C2 pathway, C3 pathway, C4 pathway or C5 pathway or C4 pathway. So the correct answer is the fourth one. The plants which are found in the dry tropical conditions, they show the C4 pathway because they are photosynthetically more efficient than compared to the C3 plant. So the correct answer is the fourth one. Then last question. Which of the following is the first compound that accepts carbon dioxide during the dark phase of the photosynthesis? So initial acceptor of CO2 during the dark phase or during the C3 cycle of photosynthesis is the RuBP. So the correct answer is the second one. Ferredoxine, cytochrome, these are the intermediate electron carriers, and NADP is the coenzyme. Thank you for watching.